Hello, I'm Stacey Hayes, and welcome to Star Trek the Tour. Throughout Star Trek's 5 TV series and 11 movies, one thing has remained unchanged. The undying spirit and devotion that Star Trek fans hold deep in their hearts. This spirit is the driving force that propelled a team of hundreds, including entrepreneurs, artists, and craftsmen, to create the greatest tribute to the Star Trek legacy the world has ever seen. I have been tasked to bring you the behind-the-scenes story of what it took to put together 50,000 square feet of ships, sets, aliens, and props. And maybe, if we're lucky, we'll learn a few Trek secrets along the way. First off, let's find out how this project got started. Martin Bialis is the head of Sea Touring Productions. He's responsible for the initial idea and getting the project off the ground. But before production can commence, there are many logistical matters that need to be taken care of. The man for the job? Bob Dahl. He bears the burden of making sure deadlines and standards are being met. With financing and a venue in place, it was time to bring the design team in. Master production designer Herman Zimmerman would lead the creative team headlong into a daunting challenge. The main design elements for the show were decided upon. Recreations of the original series bridge, the Enterprise D bridge, the Guardian of Forever, and an Enterprise D corridor were all built. Other elements that were created from scratch include the entrance rotunda and the encounter theater. Next step, on-site assembly. It's time to bring in the crew that will be putting everything together. With construction well underway, I was able to catch up with Martin's right-hand man, John Purdy. He is the producer for Star Trek The Tour, and his hands-on approach makes him the ideal candidate to reveal some little-known Trek facts. So here we are behind the scenes, so many fascinating things to look at, to talk about.
Pretty special.
Really, right? I mean, the first time so much of this has been experienced and seen, certainly in the United States.
Yes, it is.
So it's beyond fascinating. Tell me about it. Tell me about the challenges. I mean, what goes into making something this fabulous?
Well, we started about 10 years ago with a tour we called the World Tour.
So everyone is going to get the chance, hopefully, to experience this. So tell us what is looming here behind us, a recreation, right, of the original bridge?
Well, for the very first time in the United States, this is the original bridge. This is where Captain Kirk and Mr. Spock and the gang gathered on a weekly basis. The entire cast is in there with you.
So there's so many fabulous things to look forward to, but tell us, what do you think is going to be an absolute fan favorite?
In the middle of the exhibition, something goes terribly wrong.
Oh!
We're under attack by some rogue Klingons and a stolen battle cruiser, and, you experienced it up close and personal on 12 multimedia screens.
Oh, I love it! So Herman Zimmerman brings his incredible expertise. Tell us.
Even more so, we bring Herman Zimmerman out of retirement.
Oh, I love it!
He is the man. He has the vision. And we sat down with Herman, we said to him, here is what we would like to show to the American public.
You didn't leave anything out, did you?
Oh, there's much more.
Oh, there is. Tell us. Oh, this I have to see. This is very exciting.
We've all heard about the Christie's auction.
Mm-hmm.
And the fabulous prices everything bought. Well, all of this is taken before with stuff is sent to Christie's. So this is the very, very primo material.
So we're the lucky ones. We get to see the goods. Right. So let's go have a peek at this $2 million model you're telling me about.
It's right this
way. Let's do it. I can't wait.
This we uncovered at the last minute from the vaults of Paramount. And my dear, are you ready?
I'm ready.
If you'll help me.
Okay.
It's almost like a game show.
I know, right?
What would Chuck Woolery say? And the 1701D.
Oh, my word.
This is a shooting model from the Next Generation. This model was shot perhaps more than any of the others. You see the decal work on it?
Wow, that is really cool.
Indeed, a special moment in the Star Trek legacy. Stacy, come on. This is it. The saucer corridor from the 1701D.
Oh, right.
Captain Picard's living quarters.
Okay.
For the first time, the fans are up close and personal with the material.
Right.
Herman Zimmerman, the original surfacings, it's immaculate.
But you're like 30 days away,
well,
right?
Yes.
And there's still so much to be done. Are you nervous?
No, I'm waiting for the moving vans. And, And down here.
Okay, what is this?
What do you think? Look
is
a little
it a sick
medicinal.
Bay?
It is. It is. Very good.
Good.
Dr. Beverly Crusher's sick bay. And a lot of the original props will be in here, too. So
oh, really?
It's a marvelous photo opportunity. And you can bring your camera anytime to the exhibition. And I've got something very special.
What do you have?
Well, this is kind of, as we say, immersive.
Okay.
Right? What do you think this might be? Come on over
oh,
here.
Oh, no. Is this where I can be beamed up?
Yes, it is.
Oh,
this
I
is the transporter room.
Oh, I want to do this.
And this is available as a lenticular postcard that you can take home.
No.
So you relive the experience over and over again.
Oh,
what's the magic words?
Beam me up, Scotty. Love it.
It's an honor to be here, and it's an honor to show it to you. This is the dome at the Queen Mary, which, you know, wow, you know. Could you ever think that Star Trek would be at the dome at the
no,
Queen Mary?
No, I never would have thought.
Isn't it very special?
It is.
50,000 square feet of 40 years of the Star Trek legacy under the dome at the Queen Mary.
Still a lot of work to be done, yes?
Yeah, but well underway. Under budget, ahead of schedule.
Well, there you go. Doesn't get much better than that, then.
Right here will be the Grand Arch, and supporting the arch are a series of costume cases and video modules. And in the video modules, we salute all of those people. Gene Roddenberry's tribute, narrated by Son
His
Rod.
Son, I heard that. I think that's wonderful.
And even Rod says, you know, what we've done to salute Gene is the very best that was ever done. And it's the first time this has all been seen. I found out things about Gene Roddenberry that I didn't
know. Did you? That's fabulous. And so worthy of that, too.
Next up, I'm going to get a tour of some of the coolest props and models from the guardians of all things Trek, the husband and wife team of Michael and Denise Okuda.
So I'm looking at all these display units. It looks like there's a lot of work to be done. Tell me, what's going on here? This is fascinating to me.
Well, we have eight units like this. They have domes over them. I think when they're lit, they're going to look really cool. But you're right, this is a work in progress. There's such a wealth of items that we have that we kind of had to come up with an organization. And we're just kind of going in chronologic order.
This dome is principally Star Trek The Next Generation. This is actually one of the photographic miniatures for one of our shuttle pods. And Rick Berman was the one who suggested it. Berman had worked with Professor Elbaz on a documentary years ago, so he said, yes, let's name it for him.
It's been kind of challenging to find what we think are the most interesting recreations. Mm-hmm. Some of these are original props. And each of these domes, we're starting like with Enterprise, which was before the original series, and going on and on. So when the guests come into the show, they'll be following a timeline.
Okay,
and this
I
will
see.
Be one of the ways that we display that timeline.
Very good, so creative, so much time, so much work, so much focus clearly goes into this.
The cool thing is that these domes are gonna let you get up close to the props and you can see the amazing workmanship and the design that went into these things.
You know, Star Trek is supposed to be the peaceful exploration of space.
Yeah, we have
Michael,
all these weapons.
How many weapons do we have?
Well, we have blasters,
knives.
We have phasers,
we
have knives.
You know, so like I said, it's all in the meaning of peace. But we have a lot of weapons.
But space
well
is a dangerous place.
Yes,
this
it is.
Is true.
It's absolutely
this
dangerous
is true.
Place.
What is this?
This is a Romulan blaster.
Oh.
Be careful
I
where you
like
point
it.
That thing.
Okay, I will behave.
Yes.
Oh.
But look at the workmanship
at
on this. Look at the detailing. This is the folks who design and manufacture Star Trek props. I mean, they're world class. We
absolutely.
Really couldn't ask for anything better.
And there's some good weight to this too.
Yeah. Well,
so, like,
you know, Romulans
really have
are
like this. Powerful weapon. I'm pointing it again.
Yes.
Yeah,
you can take it away from me.
But that's good for the actors because when the actor carries it,
it feels real.
It gives them the sense that this is a real thing.
The other thing that's really amazing about Star Trek is that props were created a long time before they really happened. I mean, this particular item right here is was used in Star Trek The Next Generation movies. It's a pad. Our PDA is all the time now.
Of course.
And it's just, you know, it's part of our way of life, but not back when Star Trek was created.
Yeah, that's
so
true.
It's really amazing.
Very advanced.
This is years before cell phones, iPhones, or Palm Pilots. Then Star Trek came up with this, and we've talked to people who work for companies who said, yes, we were inspired by Star Trek.